While today we're used to radios, cell phones, and the internet, there was a time when it was difficult to transmit voice information directly. Morse code is a way to encode letters using just on and off, and the most common letters use the shortest sequences. Even today, amateur radio operators use Morse code because it's easier to pick up over long distances or with very little power.
Converting a word to Morse code isn't too hard. We could just pre-record all of these patterns and then play them back for each letter. But can we make a system that interprets Morse code and turns it back into text?
Using just the base nerdkit, I've written code which lets me key in Morse code with the push button, and it will interpret it as a letter and display it on the screen. I also added a piezoelectric buzzer so we can hear the key. This buzzer isn't a part of the base nerdkit, but we talk about where to get one in another video titled Making Music with a Microcontroller.
I've written a few functions which I'll describe briefly. First, I'm using the microcontroller's two timers, which are just pieces of hardware that measure a specific amount of time while our other code still can run. The first function, waitForTimerTick, uses timer 0 to count how long we're holding down the button. The next function, timeNextKeyPress, uses that waitForTimerTick function to measure how long I've held down the button in terms of that timer 0. It also does some things in case of a timeout, which is when I've waited too long between presses, or I've held it down for too long. See the source code for details. Next, I've made a big table of the letters in terms of dits and das, the units of every Morse code symbol. The way I've done this is to use some compiler macros, which are like functions but are used before the program is ever uploaded to the chip. I use 1 byte of flash memory to store the Morse code sequence for each letter. I use the highest 3 bits to tell me how many dits or das there are, and the lowest 5 bits to tell me whether they are a dit or a da. Then, I have a Morse lookup function, which will try to match a letter to the table. There's also a bitwise reverse function, which I need because of the way I chose to put the dits and das into the table. When I'm making the table, the first dit or da is in the lowest bit position, but when I'm listening and shifting in one dit or da at a time, the first one gets shifted to the higher bit position. Finally, in the main function, I set up the timers using information from the chip's datasheet. My main while loop is centered around calling my timeNextKeyPress function. Depending on the result, it decides whether to clear the whole screen, or to end the symbol and do a lookup, or just to add another dit or da. There's a lot of code here, almost 300 lines, but it's broken down into chunks that hopefully you can understand one at a time. Whenever you're building a complicated program, or any complicated system, you have to get comfortable figuring out which pieces you need and how they'll talk to each other, and then later going back and filling in the details. This is the power of abstraction.
I'm still learning Morse code, so I'm pretty slow, but let's see how well I can do. Here's another demo that actually shows me using the system. You can build all of this with the base nerdkit, except for the buzzer, which we talked about in another video. Hopefully you've learned something, and actually in the course of building this project, I've finally been learning Morse code. For the source code to this project, more information about our electronics kits, or more videos like this one, take a look at our website at www.nerdkits.com.